you and me. RPG for the family. RPG, it's a game that's going to change your life. RPG and me. RPG and me.
And then the goblins attack. Oh, well, hey there, friend. I didn't hear you come in. Well, have a seat, make yourself comfortable. While you're here, how about we play a game? I've got Monopoly. No? How about Yahtzee instead? You don't want to play that either? Say, how do you feel about swords? Magic, dragons. Well, then I have exactly the game for you. Wait right there. You see, this game is special because this is a TTRPG. In this game, you're not trying to get the most points or buy railroads. Instead, this box has everything we need to tell 100 different stories. Let's take a peek inside. Oh, these are our miniature figurines. They help us keep track of where everyone is. Map. You can have this one today. These are our dice. They're going to tell us exactly how things happen during the game. There's a rule book to help you learn how to play. Oh, this one's my favorite. This is the Game Master screen. It lets me hide dark secrets from the players. There could be anything back here, like an ogre, or even a dragon. Oh, and last but not least, the map, which you'll get to explore using your miniatures. Now, that's all well and good, but what exactly does TTRPG even mean? Well, let me spell it out for you. The T and T stand for table top. That's because this game is played across the top of a table. That table will be covered in pieces and dice and papers and maps, but we'll get to the details of how those work a little bit later. For now, just try finding a table big enough to fit you and a few of your friends. And me, if I can come. After all, we're buddies, right, friend? R and P stand for role playing. In this game, you're not just a plastic piece moving across a board. No, you are an adventurer on a journey to slay dragons, rescue fair maidens, and save the kingdom from evil. You'll play your role by describing what your character will do, and then rolling dice to see how successful they were. Let's say you're playing as Beldar the Brave. Here is your character sheet. It tells you everything that Beldar can do. Let's say that Beldar, that's you, spies a thief rummaging through his personal belongings. What do you do? Well, obviously, you and put them into custody. The town rewards you with gold pieces for putting that thief behind bars. Congratulations. Well, that's all fine and dandy. But what if you failed? Perhaps you rolled the dice and had the misfortune of rolling the dreaded. Well, in that case, the thief might retaliate, striking you with his dagger as you cry out in pain. G is perhaps the simplest of all, friend. It stands for game. Because at the end of the day, no matter what happens in the story, what matters is that we all had fun playing. So whether you win and attain the world's greatest treasure, or fail and lose. So, you think you're ready for your first game, do you? Well, I'll be the judge of that. Do you have your 20-sided dice on hand? Well then, let's begin. But first, let me set the mood. Welcome. Today, you will be playing as Beldar the Brave. You are a third-level fighter with an armor class of 4 and a 17. You have been tasked with exploring the tomb of the beyond. The local priests claim to be hearing ruckus and unrest from behind its closed doors. As you take your first step into the decrepit halls, you begin to hear... You bravely enter the next hallway, but curses! This foul place is trapped! A gout of flame erupts from the nearby wall, scorching you for 7 points of damage. Licking your wounds, you enter the final chamber. There, you find a hooded man in a black cloak. He sits at a table with maps, figures, and a large screen before him. As he speaks, he seems to describe the very room around him. The musty air weighing heavily upon your body as sweat trickles down your neck.
I'm here, friend.